Hello, Assalamualaikum and welcome to Mathematics class for Standard 6th, Chapter 2, Whole Numbers, Part 2. Students, what you are going to learn from this video? Students, you are going to learn exercise 2.2's question number 1 and 2. So let us begin. Question 1 is find the sum by suitable arrangement. Now students, how you are going to arrange these questions? You have to take the last number of each numbers and you are going to add them. You have to take pair. Pair means two at a time. So when 7 is added to 8, it does not gives you the number in whole numbers. Whole numbers means you have to add the numbers, take the pairs in such a manner that when you add them, you must get the answer 10. So while adding 7 and 8, you doesn't get 10, you get 15. When you add 8 with 3, you doesn't get 10, you get 11. But when you add this 7 and this 3, you get the answer as 10, right? So what we are going to do? We are going to make the pair of these two first. See, in this manner. So what is left last? 208, which we have not considered now, we are going to put them last. So when you are going to add these two, what you are going to get? You are going to get the answer 1200. And when you are going to add 208 to this, so as you know that 0 is the identity number for addition. So wherever zeros are there, that numbers will be same in your answer. See, so the zeros are at tens and ones place. So the tens and ones of the next number will be shown as it is in the answer. So what you have to do, you have to just add the remaining number with this number 2. That is 12 plus 2 will give you the answer 14. And in this manner, without any long calculation, you will be able to solve the sums systematically. Okay, by doing the arrangement. In the similar manner, students, what you are going to do, you are going to take the next question. Wait. The next question is this: 1962, 453, 1538 and 647 in the similar manner, how the arrangement is done and the calculation is easy for you. Okay, students. So now let us move on to the next question, number 2. Here you can see the first, again the arrangement is there, and as you can see, 2 multiplied by 50 will give you hundreds. And 100 multiplied by 1768 will give you 1768 with double zero. This is how with proper arrangement you must know what you know for this multiplication. You must know the tables of 50, 25. So because only these numbers are there which will help you, these tables will help you that after multiplication of 25 with what number, you get hundreds, you get 200s like that, right? You get. Okay, so in this manner it will be helpful for you. So you must by heart two tables, that is 25's table, which already I taught in the live classes, and 50's table, and this also I have taught all the students of my class in the live classes. As you can see, the next question is 4 multiplied by 25 will give you 100. See, the arrangement has been done, and 100 multiplied by 166, so what you'll get 16600 like that. Now, as you know that for multiplication, only one is the multiplicative identity for multiplication, identity number. So whatever number you multiply by one, you just write down it, and the remaining two zeros are just being copied in the answer. In the similar manner, students, C, D, E, F, all questions are to be solved. So you can see for C questions, it is the table of 125. If you have learned the table of 25, then the table of 125 automatically becomes very easy for you to understand. So 125 multiplied by 8 will give you 1000, and 1000 multiplied by 291 will give you the direct answer 291000. In the similar manner, students, the 16, if 625 multiplied by 16 will give you 10,000, and 279 multiplied by 10,000 will give you 279,000 as your answer. Students, in the similar manner, question E and F is also there. You can see 5 multi here, 25 table is not there, 50 is also not there, but 5 is there. And after multiplication of 5 with this 60, you'll get the answer 300. So it became easy now. Now here, 1 is not there, for it is not 100. Here the number is 300. So what you have to do in the rough, you have to calculate 285 multiply by 3. So what answer you are going to get it, you are going to use it. But here they have taken one another step. 285 is nothing but 300 minus 15 and multiply by 3. Distributive property they have used and they got the answer. So this is how they have used one tactic, logical method, that how it is very close to 300 and after just subtracting 15 from 300 we are going to get 285. So they have used this method. So this is also could be done, or you may directly do what, you may multiply 285 by 3 in your rough, get the answer and just put two zeros after that. I hope, student, you understood this thing, because if you're going to use this method, you have to first of all go for multiplications. It's easy. 3 threes are 9 you're going to get, and 0000 you're going to just write down after 9, and then you have to go for subtraction. Students, you may follow these method, no problem. I hope you understood in the similar manner. The down one is there, it is just a mere arrangement. You can see 40 is been arranged with 25 for multiplication, and 125 has been multiplied by 8, so you get 1000 and 1000. So total there will be 3 and 3, 6 zeros after 1 multiply by 1. 1 multiply by 1 is 1, 1s are 1, and this 3 0 and this 3 0, that is total 6 zeros are to be written after 1. I hope, students, you followed this, how the arrangement is to be done. The next question number is 3, students. Here also you have to find the value by using distributive property. For using distributive property, let us go on for the first question. You can see here 297 and 297 are both same. Here addition is there, only this sign is actually having multiplication. Here plus will come, okay, and 17 plus 3 will be written in the bracket, and two numbers which are same on both the side will be written here. So 297 multiplied by 20 will give you, see how 20 has been separated. First of all, 2 is written here and then 10. You multiply 297 by 2 and then just add 0 to that. So the answer will be very quick and fast for these sums. The next question is B. You can see 54,279 is the same number here. You have to just take 98 plus 8 in one of the bracket. It makes 100. And when you are going to multiply this with 1, you get the same answer, 5427. Only you have to do what? You have to add this 20 afterwards. I hope, students, you are understanding. Similar for this one, 169 minus 69 will come in the bracket. And 81,265 is the same number on both the sides. So we are going to take it common outside the bracket. 169 minus 69 will give you 100, and 81265 after multiplying with 100 will be having only two zeros last at the same number. I hope, students, you can do this. Students, the last question D is little bit arrangement kind, as well as a little bit of complexity is there. What, you know, only the thing you have to do, this is 5, no, none of the questions numbers are matching, you can see. So what we'll do, we'll bifurcate this 25 as 5 multiply by 5. So what will happen, see, this 5 multiply by 5, after 5 multiply by bifurcation, you just take these two numbers in one of the set like this, multiply and see what answer you get. You get the similar answer now on both the side. You get 5 on both the side, right? So you multiply this as 1 and you take this number 282 plus 218 on this in the bracket. When you're going to multiply this, you'll get the answer 19225, and addition of this will give you 1000, and you just have to put three zeros at the end of the 19225 number. Now, student, the logical or a little complexity which you find in this question is actually this, 25. You have to bifurcate this 25 as 5 multiplied by 5. Only this logic you have to apply for this sum. I hope students you have followed all the sums. You are going to solve it correctly. The PDF also will be sent to you. Okay, students. So you have to copy all these sums in your CW book and you have to keep your CW books ready. Okay, students. So I hope you can do this. Till then, okay, students, we are going to meet with another video. Till then, have a blessed day ahead. Goodbye.